Good afternoon, YouTube. One of the products we offer are spring eye bushings. So this is the bushing that goes into the spring eye. Your leaf springs will generally have a bushings on one end, and then they'll have a set of bushings on the other end. They may or may not be the same size depending on the vehicle. One of the questions we get a lot is, what size bushings do I need? If you've got your springs all put together like this, and then they're on the vehicle, and you've got the spring shackle covering up that bushing, how do you know what size bushing you need? The bushings are sized by the inside diameter of the spring eye, which is the outside diameter of the bushing. There's also the inside diameter, the bushing, which determines what size bolt you need to go through here. So these bushings happen to be 30 millimeters on the outside, 18 millimeters on the inside there. These are a little bit worn. They're used bushings. These would be used with an 18 millimeter bolt, and then they fit into a 30 millimeter spring eye. But like I said, what if you have the springs all put together and you can't take the bushing out and you don't want to remove the spring shackle because maybe the nut on the other side is rusted in place and you can't get it apart? And the reason you're replacing your spring eye bushings and shackle is because it's all rusted together and you know you're going to have to cut the thing apart to get it out, and it makes it really hard to check. Well, it's really easy to check this if you have a dial caliper. Just come over here. You're going to measure the thickness of the leaf. This is your main leaf, and it's the one that makes the tight curl up there. Yeah, it's roughly 7.5 millimeter thick leaf spring. And then just measure the outside diameter of the spring eye. And you want to measure this one, not this military wrap here. You want the inside there. And you can see 45. And if you subtract off 7.5, 7.5, that's 15. 45 minus 15 is 30, which is that diameter. The other common Toyota spring eyes are 36 millimeter, which a lot of the T100s have. Assuming the same 7.5 millimeters, you're going to take 36 plus 15 is 51 millimeters. Now, this isn't a Toyota pickup bushing. I think this is off of a Jeep, but the later model pickups and the Tacomas and later vehicles like that will have a bushing with a sleeve in the middle. And so there'll be a steel sleeve slipped through this bushing, and they're generally 40 millimeter diameter, assuming the same 7.5 millimeter thick leaf. 40 plus 15 would be 55 millimeter outside diameter. So just measure the outside diameter of this, and you can figure out what the inside diameter is. But you might have a different thickness spring, so you need to measure your thickness and then measure the outside diameter here and then subtract off two spring thicknesses, and that's the outside diameter of the bushing you need. There's not going to be a 32.6 millimeter bushing. There's 30, 36, and 40. That's the three sizes Toyota's used over the years. Now, on the Land Cruisers, they've got other sizes. This is mainly the pickup and 4Runner models, Tacomas. That's the main ones we do spring shackles and bushings for. But yeah, you can have different size bushings on either end of the spring, so be sure to check both sides. So yeah, I just thought I'd show you that little tip. You know, people get confused. You know, how do I measure? You know, I've got the leaf springs in the vehicle. The spring shackles are covering up the end. I can't even see the bushing. You know, how do I measure it? I'll just measure the spring and then subtract off the thickness of the leaf. So yeah, if you have any questions about that, I'll put a link to our webpage in the video description. And as always, thanks for watching.